The different styles of hops that are available at the homebrewers are huge. Over the last few years, there's been several universities that are cultivating their own new and different breeds of hops. Most hops that you can find commercially at homebrew shops are English style, Belgian style, American style. They typically are named Cascade, Amarillo, Simcoe, Fuggles. There's a lot of different names that were given to the hops where they were originally produced. Now there are so many hops being produced at universities that they need to be numbered. So we're already into 3 and 4 and 5 digit numbers of hops. The variety and the amounts of bittering that you can get or aromas that you can get, they're all being scientifically engineered now. The ones that are available to homebrewers have all of those characteristics: heavy bittering, very floral. I mean, you'll have a hop called Citra hops, which is, you know, its name makes you think of citrus. So it'll have a lot of those citrus-like aromas. Or, you know, they've been very creative in naming the hops. You can get as much bitterness from a high alpha acid to a high floral, or the beta amylases that are involved in all the lupin glands and the oils that are in these flowers. They're basically flowers. So the longer you boil them, the more you change the hop to, you break down those oils and provide all that the bitterness or aromatics that you'd like. You can, at the end of your boil, if you want a very, very floral product, you just put your dried hop flowers in your beer, or let them sit even in your fermenter. So the hops are able to spice up or floral up or whatever you'd like to do with your hops, they'll be available.